Hey everyone, Tony Boston from ThinkUB.com. In this video, we're going to look at the UDI quadcopter, U818A. We're going to do a modification to accept a bigger battery from Neewer. It's a 3.7 volt, which is stock for this quadcopter, but it's a 1200 milliamp hour battery as opposed to the stock 500 milliamp hour battery. This battery is quite a bit larger, as you could see from the pictures. It wouldn't be able to just slide under the camera as the normal battery does. So what we're going to do is cut into the top of the casing to allow the battery to slide in from the top. This is a simple mod that only involves a small Phillips screwdriver, a Sharpie or pencil, and a utility knife. Or as you'll see, I use a Roto-Tool. So let's start by removing the housing, which is also the prop guard. First, we have to remove the small LED light that's attached with a single Phillips head screw. Now we're going to remove the plastic housing from the metal frame. You see that there are splits at each prop arm. Just spread the plastic apart and slide the arm through. Do this for all four arms. Be careful not to cut or damage any of the wires. They're all bunched together under the housing. Use the new battery to mark the top of the housing. Draw a box around the battery with the pen or Sharpie. Make it a little bit smaller than the battery itself. This way, friction will hold it in place. Once you're happy with the layout of the new battery compartment, use a utility knife to carefully cut along the line. The plastic is soft, so you shouldn't have a problem cutting through it. I just bought this Roto-Tool and bit kit from Amazon, and this was the first chance I had to use it. Only remove enough plastic to get the battery to fit snugly in place. Make sure to remove any burrs or debris and then test fit the battery. Now take a look at the layout of your battery connector plug and the position of the front LED light. The white propellers should be on the same side as the white LED light. This is the front of the copter. You want to drill a hole in the prop guard so that the battery can plug into the connector underneath without interfering with the props. Again, I'm going to use a Roto-Tool for this, but the tip of a utility knife will work well too. Now reinstall the prop guard onto the metal frame. Again, be sure to position the white LED light on the same side as the two white props. Also, be careful not to pinch or damage any of the wires. reinstall the LED. As you can see, I installed the prop guide backwards. It can go either way, but it's nice to be able to see the white light from a distance and know it's the front. I noticed it after I made the video and turned it back around off camera. Install the battery in its new compartment. Be sure not to push down too hard as the wiring and electronics are below. Pass the connector through the hole you made in the guard and plug it in. Make sure you take up the slack in the wire by tucking the connector into the housing. This way, it won't interfere with the props. Here you can see that the prop guard has now turned the correct way so that the LED light is on the same side as the camera. Now you're ready for the maiden voyage. Now that the modification is complete, let's go back and try it with the original battery to see how she flies. In my next video, I'll do a comparison of the flight times between these two batteries. Thanks for watching. I hope this video helps you to modify your quad to get some extra flight time. And if so, please hit the like button below and be sure to stop by thinqb.com, where you are what you think you be.